Hello, everyone. It's Nancy. I want to show you guys my Hobonichi flip through Fauxbo Nichi flip through for the month of December. I'm sorry about my voice. I've had a couple of really terrible weeks. The Sunday after Christmas, I fell on the ice. And I broke four bones in my foot. These bones right here. But they didn't come dislodged or anything, so they were able to just put a removable cast on my foot, but it was very painful. I can't drive, and it's getting better though. So the swelling is now starting to go down and the pain is getting better. And I've really missed doing my videos. I missed doing the dare to draw thing, which I just really started. I've been enjoying everybody else's videos on what they did with their Fobonichis and their planner systems. Also, I want to dear Corey sent me a whole bunch of stickers. She sent me some stickers back in October or early in November with I think it was October because I had Halloween stickers in there. And I was telling her that I live 80 miles away from Michael's and Hobby Lobby and Joann's, and I don't get down there too often. And so she sent me a big package of them, and I've used a lot of Christmas ones in my Fobonichi, so you'll be able to see those here. And then she went and sent me another big package of beautiful stickers for the upcoming holidays, and I just wanted to share those with you. Thank you so much, Corey. I so appreciate it. Really, I've been really bummed out because of this whole winter thing, and they don't take care of the roads or the sidewalks or anything around here where I live. So it's very dangerous to be out, and didn't realize how dangerous until this last couple of days after Christmas. First of all, she gave me a sweet card with she wanted to make sure I was stocked up on goodies for my long winter ahead. She gave me a whole bunch of beautiful washies on this card, this laminated card. And there's bears and doggies. It kind of looks like a circus thing here with some ducks and very cute chevrons, flowers in two different places. I'm going to be using these sooner than later, not because I'm so sick of winter already and it just started. And then really cute different types of patterns of washi there. And I thank you so much. I'm going to use these up really quick. Then I got some really cute cupcakes, large ones. So those will look perfect in my Fobonichi. Some stars with glittery holographic type of stars. I haven't looked at a lot of these because I wanted to save it for my haul video. Look at campfire stuff, being outdoors. That's time for s'mores. That's very cute. Yep, I'll be able to use these. I like the outdoors except in the winter because I can't, I fall. Bluebirds and clouds. That's what I need, some bluebird of happiness. Maybe I'll put those on sooner than later too. Beautiful spring flowers. Oh, some vintage Coca-Cola stuff. Oh, I love it. I'm 61 years old, so I remember all of these things. Cute bears, holographic bears. I think they're bears. Oh, they're different things. Frogs, bears. Looks like a cat and a dog. Very cute. Oh, look at this. Mermaids. Oh, pretty. So cute. They look like doodles. Cool, fun. Light bulbs. Very colorful. Oh, look at this. Well done, good work. I'll be using this when I want to pump myself up a little bit. Give myself a well done sticker for the day when I do well. Cute little kawaii stickers, cupcakes. I just love this stuff. I've been doodling in the kawaii. I look on Pinterest and I've been trying to learn how to draw this way. So, and you'll see that shortly. Fast food stickers. Very cute. Oh, 4th of July. That's nice. Very good. That'll be really pretty. And then they're clear, so you can put them right over, you know, and you, what I could do is I could paint a flag and then put this right on top of there. Really cute. Oh, and some Easter eggs. I can't believe that it's ever going to be this nice out to be celebrating Easter, but it will come. What's this? Oh, you're extra special. Some more Easter stuff. Excellent job. Exceptional. Very cute. Little dancing rabbits holding Easter eggs. And some bunnies holding spring flowers and Easter eggs. So cute. Oh, these are so special. Look at the eggs. Some more eggs. Little bunnies. So cute. Oh, little bunny eggs. These look like photograph type of stickers. Very cute. I love these. Here's Easter. Put on my page for Easter. I don't even know when it is this year, so I'll have to find that out. Put that on there. Oh, little cars with bunnies and eggs. Oh, these are so cute. Oh, I'm really going to love using these on my Easter pages. That whole week is going to look really cool. And St. Patty's. Oh, really cool. I've never seen these kind. They have like a background of different, houndstooth pattern. You know, very pretty, very pretty. I'm Irish. I play Irish music on my violin, and I have a tin whistle. So I celebrate St. Paddy's to the max. No drinking, but I like the music. Oh, another St. Paddy's. I'll be using these for sure. I love St. Patty stickers, and these are very hard to find. I don't know, there must not be very many Irish up here in northeastern Wisconsin because they don't stock a lot of things. Oh, look at there. Good luck charm, St. Patty's Day, March 17th, pot of gold. Very cute. Oh, thank you so much, Corey. This is sweet. Oh, here's Valentine's. She even put them in order. I did them backwards. Oh, my God. Bear hugs, forever. Oh, these are cute. I'm going to have to make a card out of these for my hubby for Valentine's Day. Oh, and big smooches and hearts for Valentine's. So cute. Thank you so much, Corey. I really appreciate it. I'm going to do a special card for you and send it off back to you. Because that's what I love to do, too, is make my homemade cards for everybody. Oh, so thank you. This sure brightened my day because I've been in the dumpster lately with this everything that's been going on. Ugh. Anyway, I went in with another girl on the Fobonichi site, Facebook group. And we ordered some stuff from the Fobonichi store. I did not get a cousin because, like I said, I'm committed to finishing up my Fobonichi. And that'll run me through to December of 2015. And I'm loving it. I really do. So I didn't want to just stop and go and, you know, and leave this book half finished. So I went. And I've been, you know, assembling this little by little. But I went on the Namini paper company, and they had some baby hobonichis, hobonichi checho, and so I got one of those. I got a cover. This is the Rose Perdu cover. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that correctly. And from somebody that was selling it on the Facebook group. And so I got the cover on cover. I got a cover on this one with the cover on cover, the little foxes. And on my baby, I got the trees for my winter. And then I've got the flower ones, Flower Frenzy. And I bought these little doodads to keep your things closed. I don't know if I like them or not. I'm afraid I'm going to lose them, especially this one, because I'm taking this with me. I'm kind of using this as a planner. Yes and no. Yeah, you know, I'm drawing in it too, so I cannot not draw in this thing. So I wanted to show you kind of like what I've got, how I've got this set up, just for a quick little thing. First of all, I put my little chocolate piece of candy on there. That's a paper clip I got from Jet Pens, and I had it on a haul video. And this book is like a really nice dusty pink color. And then on the inside, it's a mint green. I put my little bookmarks and paper clips there that I had. I also got from the Hobonichi store the card slots for these. I'm thinking about using this partially as a wallet to house my other cards. I have a lot of cards, you know, insurance cards and stuff, and I don't need to be always having that in my wallet. It kind of makes it thick. So I thought about putting them in here because I intend to keep this in my purse. The first section I have is paper clipped, and these are my habits checks. And this is what I'm using. So I went through the whole month of December. I'm so proud. And then with you guys aren't going to believe this, but I've been doing Weight Watchers, and I haven't been doing so good. And then when I fell down and I can't get up to eat anything, I've lost 4 pounds since December 22nd. So yay for me. But I've been keeping track of this. If I eat a green or not, I'm on Coumadin, and I have to have one serving of green every day. I'm supposed to. I have to drink a tummy drink. If I track my food or not with the Weight Watchers. If I did any exercise, there's no exercise since December 28th because I'm in a cast. And then if I played my music or not, practice my violin. So that's working out well for me. I'm enjoying that. Then for the month of December, on the monthly chart, I did a little drawing, doodling my day, a little picture a day for the whole month. And there's a couple of stickers in here and some washi. And but for the most part, it's doodling. I thought about putting my appointments in here, like I have my dentist here. And that my husband was sick, but then after that, I just decided to draw little pictures of every day. Christmas is so colorful, and I enjoy it. It's my favorite time of year, even though this year did not work out very well for me. This month, I've been using this since I want to use this kind of like as my planner. I'm going to put my appointments here and different things that I have to remember, my grandson's birthday, day my mother passed away. And I'm an accountant, so this year, this time of the year is just nutso for me. So being off of work already for a whole week, I'm so totally far behind. So I just have some dates in here that I want to remember. Then for it starts the Techo starts on December 24th with 2 days to a page. So I kind of did a little bit of journaling and put some those stickers that I was telling you about that Corey Shearer sent to me in the fall. And you see how bright and colorful that they are. And they really make the page. I think. And then I use different colors in my pen, my little Coletto pen. I use for this book, this Coletto pen. And then I've got a color in this page yet, but this is the day I broke my stupid foot. I drew a pen that my hubby gave me for one of my Christmas presents, and oh my goodness, did I get a haul, I tell you. He spoils me every year. But I thought that this white jotter pen would be, you know, he knows that I love the Field Notes pen, so he got me this little bugger, and he thought that it would look nice with this book, which it does. So I got to color these in, and the 31st, there was no party here. I also got a cold. Everybody was sick with this stupid cold at the ER, and so naturally, I brought it home with me. I gave it to Bob first, and then I got it. And so basically, we struggled to stay up till 12 o'clock on the 31st and didn't do anything on the 1st. So here's what I want to kind of do for, you know, some goals and then the January to-dos. I want to definitely do more art pieces, and I want to improve my health in 2015 and really try to work on my eating and lose weight and my general health. I'm 61 and, you know, things start falling apart. Here's some of my little kawaiis that I did from Pinterest, and they were really cute to do. I've got to work on, you know, the shapes and everything. And then I haven't colored these in, but these are some more kawaiis. I don't know if you could see that. So I haven't, you know, done a whole lot in this book. I do a little bit of to-do list and a little bit of what I did during the day. Here's some more. It's been so blasted cold up here. It's just ridiculous, but I haven't had to go outside, not for a thing. I've found people to help me with my garbage, but now I gotta do it this weekend. So I gotta take out garbage. That's on my to-dos. I got the happy mail from Corey on Monday. And then I wrote a little bit about how frustrating it is being stuck inside the house. Here I went to the doctor's. A friend of mine took me to get, you know, everything and groceries and everything. So I wrote about that. This is, I went back to work this last Wednesday, and that's when those cartoonists were murdered in France. And I did a little drawing on Thursday. I haven't painted it in yet, but I'll do that, and I have to draw some stuff on yet. So that's my little baby, Nietzsche, and I really love it. Oh, and I bought some the extra bookmarks. I don't have them doing anything right now, though. In the back, I have some post-it notes stuck on my pencil board, my homemade pencil board that I made with cutting board from the dollar store. You get two big sheets for a dollar, so I cut that. And then with the Hobo Nietzsche, the Nanami paper sent me a blotter sheet, so I have that clip back here. And then I put in like a monthly calendar just in case I might need it for something. And I've got these little schedule or diary stickers back here that I bought from Jet Pens, and some of these masking tapes, and that's about it. And stuff to receipts to turn to send back stuff. So that's it, and I really love it, and I'm gonna take that with me everywhere. Okay, so enough about that. Here is my December Fauxbo Nietzsche flip through, and I bought the little pink one for, you know, to kind of contrast it, and I've got my piece of green chocolate up here, my chocolate clip from Jet Pens, and some more some more paper clips, and then my decorated binder clip. I did, as other people had suggested, I did line my book with some cardstock. I glued it one night, and so I don't want this book to fall apart before I'm done using it. So I did the front and the back covers with cardstock, and you can see I did not glue the edges very well. I entitled this Doodling Your Day. That's what I entitled my Fauxbo Nietzsche planner. So let's find December 1st. All right, December started out very cold. And so I have lots of blanket type of pictures on here and nap type of pictures. Bob was very sick again this December. But I think we have the problem fixed up. And I like this quote that for that day, you never lose a dream, it incubates as a hobby. So, and that is so true. It's going to come out no matter what you want to do. If you want to draw, be creative, you know, it's got to come out some kind of way. And I really have missed being very creative this month with all the plans for Christmas and everything. So I still like to do the moon phase and the high and low temperature and what it was like. And I also have been including the sun up and sun down. And, you know, I had no idea that we, you know, at the lowest point of the day, we only got like 8 hours of sun. So enjoying using those stickers. These are Corey stickers and plus some other ones that I had. Bob got pretty ill, and I took him down to Green Bay to the hospital, and they had to send out for 30 miles to go and get him the medicine that he needed. He had a pretty bad infection. And when we were driving home, Green Bay is on Lake Michigan, and they had kind of like a snow squall, and you couldn't even see anything in front of you. So it took us 3 hours to get home that night. So didn't do a doggone thing when we got home. I sat down and I watched GH and that General Hospital. That's my daily, you know, treat for myself. So, but at least that drug worked. Put some washi here, did a little bit of, I think because of the white knuckling all the way home, I got a stiff neck and had it for the whole day, getting Christmas presents in. I bought a Christmas quilt for myself to put on my bed, and I kind of was detailing what, you know, if Bob was eating or anything. Oh, and I also paid bills that day. Money is flying out the window. No, I didn't color that. Guess I forgot. Okay, here's some early birthday or Christmas presents for me. Oh, and some more stickers. Corey sent me. I bought that handbag of holding. I just love that thing, and I haven't used it yet. But I really love it. It's just beautiful, and it's got purple lining and umpteen million places to put things. So I'm really looking forward to that. Bob also gave me a pair of Propay Blizzard ankle boots, and these work really nice out in the snow and the ice. They did not help me very much because I actually tripped over a chunk of ice that I didn't see on the ground. So I bought Bob some presents, and they came, and had good food choices today for my Weight Watchers. And I watched the goodbye video of Pocket Full of Vintage, and that was very sad. I'm going to miss her videos and her insight on journaling and things, and I hope she is doing well. And so then the next day, saw my to-dos, not getting anything done, and had a big headache, and it's just, you know, I just haven't been, I'm like, have you ever been really, really busy and still not getting ahead? I don't know. That's just the way my whole month went. Some more washi tape. I bought some wrapping paper. That was on Saturday. I went to Michael's and got a bunch of different things. I bought some stamps and some stamp pads with the pigment ink. And I watched a video and just describing both the inks, pigment and dye-based ink. And just think of pigment ink as paint. It sits on top of whatever. And so that stuff really, the pigmented ink does not bleed through. So I was really happy for that. So I got a bunch of those colors, and I was glad of that. I make my own cards. So this year I did a watercolor scene, and I'll show it to you guys in the next video. It's way up in my art room. And so I did a lot of cutting and putting the copies of the painting on the card, made mats and things. And I actually cooked that night. Here's another little kawaii drawing. Football day, Monday night football. We had a good time watching that. Worked on my Christmas songs with my violin. I like to play Christmas songs and have the kids sing with me, and instead of just listening to the songs on the radio and stuff. Here's another kawaii practice drawings. I also did the goofy dog as a kawaii. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. I'm not sure. And have him be held up with balloons. And he says, I will find a way to get treats. And he will. And oh, Bob had a deer meeting. And so I sat out in the Shell parking lot and listened to YouTubes. And that lottery was in the sign was in the window, so I just drew that. Then this present came. I do a lot of my shopping because I'm so far away from everything. I do a lot of my shopping online. So my granddaughter's little Elsa doll came, so I had to draw that. And then it was Emily Dickinson's birthday, and I put a little poem down there that she had done. And my friend sent me a paper bead bracelet and some Christmas decorations for Christmas, my Christmas present. Went to the dentist, and it was just a beautiful day. And my feet sure do love those Propays. I have really bad arthritis in my one ankle, the foot that I broke naturally. So finding good shoes that are good to my feet is really special. Then I can go all day. I worked on my Canon and D song on the violin, and I've been working on it forever. And the dog has decided that he can't stand it anymore, and he lets me know it and by barking, and so that I stop playing. So I guess I'm going to just beg my instructor to move on from this song because it's not getting any better. And then worked on my cards, so I loaded up my my little Scotch tape runner. And this Saturday, the 13th, we went shopping, and so I kind of drew everything that I bought, and I got dressed up for Christmas, and we had a really nice time. And I saw this in some magazine, Haul Yeah, and so I thought that it was appropriate that I put it there. And Sunday, last Christmas shopping online. My son bought my grandchildren each a Kindle, and so I bought the covers for them, and so they're gonna love those, and they do love them. This is as far as I got with my Christmas tree, decorating my Christmas tree. Yes, in the book. It's just too big for me. I just can't do it. So Bob says, just let's put this little tree up in the window, and that's it. Worked on some, so that turned out nice now, because now I wouldn't have been able to take all this stuff down. So I'm so glad that I just put up the little 3-foot tree. Did some calligraphy. I also got another early Christmas present for myself, and it's a Winsor & Newton 45 colors. It's from the UK. I don't know why they don't sell them here, like in Michaels or whatever, but I'm really having a good time with those. I'll be anxious to do some actual paintings with that stuff. Worked on Christmas cards, got them almost done. Look at it, it's the 16th. And we had TV dinners. Excuse me. My to-do list, my never-ending to-do list, and it just is not getting done. Got some more boxes from Amazon, all boxes that I have to wrap yet. All I can think of is Anne Lamott's book, Bird by Bird, where she talks about, you know, having to write this huge report, and her father saying, well, you just have to do it one by one, and that's all there is to it. So instead of working on stuff, I ended up watching GH and Mike and Molly, Procrastinators Are Us. We'll do it tomorrow. So here I get my act in order, and I'm really busy wrapping presents. I drew myself as being a tornado, getting the cards out, making dinner, mopping the floor. And I even had time to draw a little Christmas thing. I used Inktense pencils, and then I also used a Uni Signal white pen for the stars. Again, I had a lot of energy, so I had the tornado. I was busy. I did all sorts of stuff, wrapping paper and all sorts of things. Practice my Christmas songs. And then I painted a little poinsettia, some more stickers from Corey. Last minute everything, presents sent. I went to my lesson and she passed me on my Canon D. Boomer is very happy. And I did all my shopping for my food and everything for Christmas dinner, and everything got done on the 20th except for the tree. And then we watched The Wizard of Oz that night. Oh, this was the day that we decided not to put the tree up. The shortest day of the year, the 21st, and that was the make or break day that I was going to put the tree, and Bob says just forget it. So I did, and I'm glad I did. Wrapping, more wrapping paper, present wrapping frenzy. My daughter was going to have to work on Christmas Eve, and then she got off, and so she decided to come up a day early, so I really had to hurry up and get everything done, because now the kids are going to have Christmas morning at Grandma's house, and so I had to get everything ready for that. Luckily, I work where I live, so I hid all the presents in my office. So it was nice. I threw them all in a big box, and Bob pushed them and put them in my office. Panic time, 23rd, but I got everything done. The 24th, I didn't get my cookies made, so I had the kids help me, and they really enjoyed that. Making a few different kinds of Christmas cookies, and I made like chicken nuggets types of things with some mashed potatoes for dinner. And some more washi and some more stickers from Corey. This is our Christmas day. The kids loved everything. We had a wonderful time. Ham, banana pudding. I bought them necklaces that glowed, that looked like little Christmas lights that lit up. The boys loved this wrestling ring, and they had wrestlers in it, so they were playing with that. Bob bought me some chocolate-covered strawberries to share with everybody. Some more stickers from Corey. See how pretty they are. So then the kids stayed with me. Danielle went home, and we did a whole bunch of stuff. It was so icy outside that the kids all took coffee cans and poured salt outside for me. And then I took Bob's scooter so that I wouldn't slip. And so we were trying to get all that ice up. I made ham and cheese casserole. We colored in coloring books that I bought the kids, and made them Sunday cones for dessert. And we made ornaments for Christmas for next year, and we took a nap together. And I read them Frozen and for bedtime, and also I read them Benjamin Bunny. Saturday was craft day. We made Santa banks out of oatmeal containers that I had been saving, and they all wanted snowmen, so they all had, three of them had snowmen banks, so we put glitter for their hats. It was a great time. I'm still sweeping up and finding glitter all over the place. And we sang Christmas carols, and we watched A Very Merry Pool Year on TV. And I took them home, or we met in Green Bay, and I took them back, and then I came home and I fell down. And this is a bracelet that the hospital gave me. I didn't go to the hospital though this day, because I figured it was just, I was just hurting from falling. But I went to bed when I got home, and poor Bob, what he had for dinner was a bowl of Cheetos and two peanut butter bars. That's it. That's all I could do. So, not very good at taking care of him. So, here is my swearing. My friend took me to the emergency room, and I have, they told me I had three bones broke in my foot, but the specialist says I have four. So no driving for 4 to 6 weeks. Yay, whatever. And then I've got this big, huge boot to wear. And my friend took me to the grocery store so I could stock up on a whole bunch of frozen stuff, because I won't feel like cooking, and I never usually do. And this was a very bad negative day, and thank God though that I have Bob's scooter. That has really helped me get around and do things around the house where I don't have to walk or anything. So I'm able to get things done at least, and without hurting my foot. The 31st was a lucky day for us. We sold our van, our old handicap van. And we said goodbye to 2014 by not doing very much, but what the heck. We're here, we're, you know, 75% healthy, and we were together, so that's all that counts. And we had money in our pocket from selling the van. So that was my December, and I'm looking forward to 2015 being better. It's not starting off that way, but it can only get better, right? Thank you so much for watching. I'm sorry this is such a long video, but I just can't get, you know, my thoughts aren't with me yet. I hope to see you guys next month, and I hope to do a Dare to Draw video soon. And I hope everyone is having a wonderful winter wherever you are. And talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye. Thanks, Corey, again.